Hello and welcome back to Heart of the Hulk. Today we're here to discuss the signing of Courtney House on loan from Wolverhampton Wanderers and the fact that Tammy Abraham is staying to fulfil the rest of his loan deal with us here at Aston Villa. Right, two really big pieces of news coming out over the past sort of 24 hours. Obviously, Courtney House was announced last night. We've got him on a loan to buy deal from Wolves, actually, which seems like a really good bit of business, actually, as we know we are very short on defenders, specifically left-sided defenders as well. I don't think we've actually got a left-footed defender at the club other than Neil Taylor. So especially in that centre-back department where we are extremely low. Really good cover for the end of the season. Obviously, we recalled Tommy Elphick. We've seen him play a couple of games. We know what we're expecting from Tommy Elphick. But, you know, this signing of House will give us that strength and depth that is needed in the Championship. Especially, you know, with the club resting James Chester against Swansea as well. Clear to see that he, as the club have been saying, have been carrying a bit of an injury, which is a shame. But when he's the only fit centre-back at the club, you know, what else are we meant to do? Courtney House, obviously being a left-sided player of centre-back, will presumably slot straight in there on the weekend when we go and play Wigan. You would assume, obviously, we've only got him on loan till the end of the season, so we're gonna want to take advantage of the time we've got with him, blood him in early. There's no time for, you know, just sort of bringing him on for 20 minutes here and there. The defence needs sorting out, and Dean Smith thinks he's good enough, that's why we've got him. We've also got the option to sign him permanently as well, which again, good bit of business, stops anything like the Tammy fiasco that we've just undergone, you know, wondering will he stay, will he go. We've got him till the end of the season, and we can obviously decide whether we want to extend that stay come the summertime. I'm sure that'll depend on financial circumstances and where we are at the end of the season as well, whether we're you know, in the Premier League or here in the Championship. I think either way, Courtney House could be here to stay, and it's a decent little bit of business. So Courtney House has actually played just about under 100 senior games. Obviously, he played for Wickham. He kind of came through their academy. Also came from Blues as well. He spent a lot of time at Blues. And then Wolverhampton Wanderers obviously purchased him, played around 60 games for them. So, you know, he's for a young lad at 23, he's played a decent amount of football and obviously been involved in the England youth setup with Grealish, as we've obviously seen him tweet welcoming him to the club. So it's great to see that, you know, maybe have a bit of an understanding with some of the players. Certainly with centre-backs nowadays, obviously, we're looking at ball-playing centre-halves. People like Axel Tanzabi, who likes to step out from the back and, you know, helps create an overload. And is always just an option there. I think, you know, House could be this kind of player as well. Obviously, we're missing Tanzabi at the minute, so House could fulfil that role right now while we wait for Tanzabi to come back to full fitness. It seems like he's a quick and strong lad as well. So at the back, you know, again, with Tanzabi when he returns, could have a very nice and mobile centre-half pairing, which Dino's going to like. Both can play football quite clearly, so it'd be good to see this potential partnership blossom as well. Obviously, we've also got James Chester and Tommy Elphick at the club, and a lot of, I think recently, certainly a lot of people have been slating James Chester, actually. He's not necessarily a Dean Smith type of defender in that he's not fantastic at passing out from the back, but this, you know, I think we're personally in debt to James Chester for all he's done. He has been the rock at the back consistently since he's joined, and yeah, maybe looking a bit touch and go recently, but when he's been ever present for Aston Villa, and as I say, playing through an injury, he's always been a sort of back to the wall type of defender. When, you know, obviously played under Steve Bruce under different occasions at different clubs as well, but he really is that kind of defender. He's old fashioned, so he's going to struggle to adapt to playing a passing game, but this guy saved us so many points. So, you know, maybe although I'd imagine he'd like to be playing every single week, it'd be good, you know, it's good to have the sort of cover that we need, so he can just, you know, have a rest here and there, make sure that knee of his is all right, and obviously give Courtney House the game time that he needs. And as well, in potentially what is even bigger news, the Tammy Abraham saga has ended. Sky have reported that he is in fact going to stay with us until the end of the season and fulfil his duty and obligation to play for Aston Villa, which is fantastic. I believe he's on 16 goals so far this season. So, you know, he's looking to easily smash that 20 goal target, maybe even reach 30. He is a fantastic striker. And a lot of people giving him some perhaps unwarranted criticism online and stuff, saying, well, if he's going to go. I could understand why people would have been frustrated if he did go on loan to Wolves. But at the end of the day, we've recalled both Jed Steer, also Tommy Elphick, and even Jordan Lydon recently as well. So, you know, it's the kind of thing, it's the risk you take with loans. That's why, obviously, this loan with Courtney House is a lot more risk-free. We've got him definitely till the summer, because that's the nature of loaning a player in the January transfer window. And obviously, with the option to buy, it puts us in a much better position than we would have been in, over the past week or so with Tammy's agent trying to get him that move to Wolves, both permanently or on loan. Obviously, doesn't have Tammy's interest at heart, because let's be honest, he'd be warming the bench for Raul Jimenez at Wolves. So it's great to see that he's staying. It'd be great to see him break that 19 goal a season, I believe it was, in the league record for Aston Villa. I think he's well on for that. He's going to do that unless there's some unfortunate injury. So it's great news that he's staying. There we go. So we've done some good business so far. We're still early in the window. Signed Kalinic. Had a bit of a horror show of a debut, didn't he, against Swansea. Be interesting to see if he starts at the weekend against Wigan. Getting Courtney House in pretty early is nice. Give him a bit more time to integrate with the squad, and obviously keeping Tammy Abraham, absolutely huge. The window's not shut yet, but with Chelsea not looking to sell, it looks like he is here to stay, which is fantastic. Hopefully we don't have another Fabian Delph situation and see him leave. But either way, Tammy Abraham is playing for Aston Villa right now, and he will probably play at the weekend. It'd be nice to see him up front. So yeah, leave your thoughts below in the comments on the signing of Courtney House, Lovre Kalinic, and also Tammy Abraham staying. Do you think our business has been good so far? Let us know. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more content from us here at Heart of the Hulk. We're pushing for that 800 subscriber mark, hoping for near 1,000 by the end of the season. We're well on track to hit that with your guys' support. So thank you very much for watching this video. So subscribe and like for more. Up the Villa.